I've had this laser cube for a year or two now, and it's a little bit the worse for wear. The USB connection is dodgy and the battery's not charging, so I'm going to see if I can fix that. Also, while I'm at it, maybe there's one or two other hacks I can do. If that's something you're into, then please stick around. So here it is, the original laser cube from Wicked Lasers. I actually really like this device. It was cheap, it's silent. Sure, it might not have the fastest scanners, it might not be the brightest laser there is, but just when you're working at home or in a small space, it's absolutely perfect. So I'm kind of disappointed that they've discontinued it. Now you can only get the more expensive and larger laser cubes, which are fine, but they have a fan in, so they're a bit noisy, and of course they're more expensive. This laser cube has had some heavy use. Yeah, it's been a bit abused, to be honest. It's been thrown into my backpack several times with the USB cable still connected, and that's probably why the USB socket stopped working. Also, the batteries don't seem to charge. I plug in the power supply and after a while it just starts flashing, so there's obviously something wrong there too. One other thing I'd really like to fix is the key switch. So the way it works is that when you turn on the laser, or if you re-engage the emergency stop interlock, you need to turn the key switch off and on again, otherwise the laser won't do anything. This is actually a safety requirement in some regions, but when you're working at home, it can just be really annoying. I'm going to try and figure out a way to get around this, but obviously if you're using this laser outside of your home, it's something you probably should check is still legal. So let's get this open. You can see there's these four main screws that hold the bottom on, and then if you turn it around the other side, you can lift the top side out. And you can see there are these hex standoffs that run throughout the length of the cube that hold the entire thing together. Here's one of the battery packs affixed to the lid, and you can see inside there's the main control board and the other battery pack. Once I unclip all these wires, it frees the main controller board from the rest of the laser components. I can lift that enclosure off. And here's the faulty micro USB connector. We're going to have a look at that later, but first I'm going to cover up the glass with some tape just to protect it. I'm going to see if I can get this key switch out. It's actually really stuck. The usual technique with a spanner isn't working, so I'm going to have to get a bit more violent. So with a great deal of effort, I finally got it out. And I'm so glad. This key switch is absolute junk. And the keys are so flimsy. It's going straight in the bin. So you might expect that I could just bridge the contacts in order to eliminate this key switch, but that's not quite the case. Because if you remember, it actually needs to be switched off and then switched on again before it activates the laser. I'll show you how to get around this later, but for now let's see if we can fix this micro USB socket. I've tried to straighten it out with some pliers, and I've given it a good clean with some contact cleaner. It's definitely a lot better, but it's not 100%, so I'm going to see if I can order a replacement part. Next, it's time to check the battery situation, and it seems that this battery pack is completely dead. Normally I'd advise that you get a replacement from Wicked Lasers, but this time my friend Paul had some spare cells which were more or less the same spec, so he made me up a new pack. All I had to do was wire it up, cover them in heat shrink, clean up the sticky adhesive mess, and stick it back on with some fresh VHB tape. The replacement micro USB socket has arrived, so it's time to get the old one off. I quite like using this technique where I just put a whole blob of solder all on the back and try and get it all as wet as possible while slowly, gently pulling it away with some pliers. I've tested the socket and it works, but I want to just strengthen this connector, so I'm going to use some Sugru. I kind of have a bit of a love-hate relationship with Sugru. It's so good when you need it, but I don't find that I use it that often, so by the time I get to use it, it's out of date. This pack is a few months past its prime, which can cause it to take ages to set, but fingers crossed we'll be okay this time. I found a button that can replace the key switch. What I need is a button that's normally closed so that when I push it, it momentarily opens the switch, and then when I let go, it goes back to being closed again. You can get normally closed buttons, but they're quite rare. More common is this type, which is dual pole, which means that you can wire it in a way that's normally closed or in a way that's normally open. In this case, I'll use the connectors marked NC and common to get the configuration that I need. The button is exactly the same size as the key switch was, so it's a straight swap. Now, whenever I turn it on or reset it, I don't have to mess around with that really annoying key. I can just push that button. It's one of those small things that really makes your life easier. So now I'm going to put the whole thing back together again. I'm pleased to report that LaserCube is working great now. The USB socket has absolutely no trouble at all. The button to reset is so much better for when I'm working here. I absolutely love it. The battery isn't like 100% perfect. I think really you should replace both the battery packs with genuine Wicked Laser batteries, but it actually works just fine for me at home. If you're not used to doing electronics, it's probably not something I'd attempt. And of course, when you're working with lasers, you've got to be doubly careful. You know, while you've got that enclosure open, there are the laser diodes that are unprotected. Just be careful is what I'm saying. If you want to try this, just be careful. And like I said about the safety, like this laser probably isn't up to the code right now without the key switch. If you're interested in learning more about how you could run a LaserCube safely in public, let me know. I'd be happy to do a video about it. Anyway, that's all for now. Hope you've enjoyed it. Subscribe, all that stuff, and I'll see you next time.